Man, I tell you, the more you live, the more you learn. And I'm talking about these YouTube streets. Kind of fitting for the song I'm playing. You gotta be high for this kind of shit.
You don't know.
Oh, I got something to say in a minute. Y'all here, I got something to say.
But you know what you need for. Close your eyes, lay yourself beside me.
Oh,
hold tight, all this wrong. We don't need
I tell you, wonders never motherfucking cease in this bitch.
We don't need attention. Open your hand.
Take a glass.
Don't be scared.
Don't be scared.
I'm right here. Even though you don't know. Trust me, boy.
Trust me, boy. You gotta be, you want for this. You gotta be high for this kind of shit.
You want it all.
Some of y'all, please don't take it off, cause that shit, I got a scar on my belly, but baby, some of the bodies I done seen, from the pictures I done seen from these niggas sending me that shit.
It's okay.
It's about two of you chicks. Y'all got some nice bodies, but what the fuck? Falling in love with an internet nigga, showing him your motherfucking shit, and then get mad when he put that shit out. Shit, you better you motherfuckers ain't gonna do that Donna Martinez challenge, though. Do that shit. But first, you gotta have a legal husband. And a lot of you hoes ain't gonna get married or have babies in this bitch. Barren bitches, crazy bitches, stupid bitches, retarded bitches, broke bitches, scamming ass for money ass bitches! I'm right here, bitch, if you wanna find me.
You don't know.
Ow!
You wanna be your wife of this.
You wanna be high for this kind of shit. And I don't get high. But you gotta be high for this kind of shit that I'm about to talk about. Hell yeah, motherfuckers, bitches, hoes, tricks, gather around. So this shit done got out of hand now.
You wanna be high for this.
If you don't get high, you need to be high for this. It's YouTube bullshit. These YouTube streets is bullshit. It's bullshit. It's bullshit. It's bullshit. Mass hypnosis bullshit. Motherfucking follow the sheeple ass shit. Too many cooks spoil the motherfucking broth kind of shit. Too many motherfuckers ain't enough leaders, but too many followers in this shit. But you know what? Social media is just the pulse of what's going on in the world. And I'm tired of you bitches that I've noticed here lately and people have pointed out. Everybody got their own style. That's just how I act the way I act. Of course, I know how to act in person and be a lady and when I'm conducting business and whatever. I know how to talk to people, whatever. Shit, you couldn't have had the kind of job I had. Shit, if I never worked. I wasn't raised around no illiterate ass motherfuckers. But you motherfuckers, with y'all fucking deformities, your low self-esteem, got raped by your daddies, by your stepdaddies, sucking your uncle's dicks, doing shit, and then you do shit, and then you're scamming motherfuckers for money. Oh, no, I ain't talking about a man. Some shit that I witnessed. I'm glad I didn't get to put a motherfucking red cent on. Motherfuckers showing half their face and shit. Talking shit. Bitch, you motherfucking nigga. Grow some motherfucking balls. Because your motherfucking balls haven't failed yet. talking shit about me. Like I don't know. Bitch, like I see, I dance with the motherfucking devil every night. Every 3 to 5 a.m. I dance with the motherfucking devil. And I'm going to tell you, he can ballroom his motherfucking ass off. You hear me? He can ballroom his motherfucking ass off. He can ballroom. Old school call it socialing. But he can ballroom. He can step like they do in Illinois. Step in the name of love. Yeah, the devil can step in the name of love too. And what you don't want out of me, you don't want to get on my motherfucking bad side, bitch and bitchettes. I'm speaking to some bitches right now. And if you a nigga and you fall in this category, bitch, like I said and said it so many times before, bitch, strap your motherfucking boots up to the motherfucking laces all the way to the top. Them old-fashioned boots from the 1800s, bitch, and walk that shit out, ho, and just strut the fuck up out of here. Walk it out, bitch, because you're going to have to walk this shit out because I'm about to be on your ass. Fuck this 2018 truth. Bitch, I'm on this shit. I'm out here. I'm out here, man. Hey man, I'm out here. You mother. Oh, I'm gonna put in the heading. LA is not a pedophile. LA is not a fucking pedophile. I said that shit. He is not a motherfucking pedophile. No, he isn't. Oh, she riding his dick. Well, you gonna let me ride his dick, but he's not a pedophile. Now shit people did the next year and put up on him. That's on you. Look it up. He ain't got shit to hide. I said that shit because of some shit I heard, but realized I had the voices mixed up because I didn't know about, as y'all call the dark sector, the black side, or people threaten you. I'm going to take you to the deep, dark well, bitch. I'll take you to the deep, dark abyss, bitch, and leave you there stranded, bitch. And you can't get back in your motherfucking body, bitch, and let a motherfucking minion, a demon take over. Because basically that's what's been going on with you anyway. You've been turned over to a retrobate mind and you ain't had no dick in a long time. Let me tell you something, ladies. It's good to be celibate, but don't be so celibate that you just go crazy. See, it ain't natural. It ain't natural to be celibate. It's not. It's really not natural. It's not fucking natural to remain celibate. Because every bitch I know that claim to be celibate, they y'all call me crazy. Now, these bitches really are crazy because they don't get no dick. They ain't got no dick in their motherfucking life. They ain't got no motherfucker to come over there and knock the dust off that pussy. Some of these bitches would shut the fuck up if they just get some dick. And some of these niggas, too. Some of these niggas, if their dick was long enough, they'd take that shit twisted like a boa constrictor and fuck their own self in the ass. Just like some of these bitches' titties, they need to go milk themselves. Well, some of you hoes need to fuck yourselves with the middle finger, bitch, curved, so you can hit that motherfucking G-spot and so you can come, bitch. Because it ain't my motherfucking fault that you've all sexually frustrated. You can tell a sexually frustrated motherfucking man or woman, they always talking bullshit. Well, you talk bullshit, bitch. I'm a shit talker. I sit in the shade, sip lemonade, and talk shit, bitch. But guess what? What I won't do is say I didn't say it. And what I can do is apologize and admit when I'm wrong. I've apologized to people that never apologized to me back when they was sicked on me first. Jamila. Yeah. Tell your little groupies over there to shut the fuck up. Tell them to put my motherfucking picture on their motherfucking altar. Tell them to do all that shit. Because what they're going to find out is going to be some shit some damn combustion blowing up in a bitch face or in Shim's face. Because I just got a motherfucking shit I just read, some screenshots. Really? But we don't owe each other nothing. Like Chris Brown say, hoes ain't loyal. Just know these motherfucking social media niggas, men and women, they ain't loyal. You do what you do. You chill with where you want to chill. You take it for what it is. Unless you motherfuckers run off to the sunset and get married, or you fuck and the motherfucker put your business out, or you send them your pussy pic or your asshole pic or your titty pic. Shit. Do like I still challenge you hoes. Do the Donna Martinez challenge, bitch. And I save that. Save that for the court date. Because, bitch, it's a method to my madness. And if you want to get caught up in my web, feel free to do so, said the spider to the fly. I'm that black widow you don't want to fuck with, bitch. And I ain't talking shit. I mean every word I fucking say. It's been proven, documented. And I'm not 5150. But I want you to think I am. Bitch, bastard, son of a bitch, bitchettes. James Gordon, no disrespect, but I'm going to take the bro. You know how you see coming? You know how James Gordon, he's smooth with that shit. Oh, James Gordon, I ain't forgot I said I'm going to tear you off. I ain't forgot. But it was really shocking to hear that some motherfuckers, you got into it with a troll. I like, damn, James. Far as I know, James is a troll. But one thing about it, he still was like a breath of fresh air. I mean, he added something different. He took a different spin, and it could be somebody we know, you know, like they have, it could be a channel holder, but he, you know, whenever there's some bullshit about to go down, you look up, there go James Gordon. And I got to give him that credit. And if he get paid, and I know if he get paid, he deserve every donation payment, because some of that shit, oh yeah, and Troll Father, that was funny, that video, but like Sir Beasley said underneath, because I was just looking under my own shit, looking for a video of some shit that I was like trying to send somebody, and I didn't even know Troll Father had even put, he put the whole 1 hour video on that shit. Now what, yeah, it was a lot of shit said on that 1 hour video. I don't know what your purpose was for it, because it really wasn't, to me, entertaining. I really don't feel that I'm funny or entertaining. Maybe I'm funny looking. Oh, that, yeah, that's a one. Oh, she opened that door. I don't care. But the motherfuckers that say some shit, they don't show their fucking face. And if they do, they ugly than a motherfucker, male and female. And that's real talk. Tell me if I'm wrong. Tell me if I'm motherfucking wrong. Flavor Flav looking ass bitches. Flavor Flav looking ass niggas. And Flavor Flav, shit, bitches was in motherfucking on MTV trying to get to be the one, the next Miss Flavor Flav. But he sure told the truth in Public Enemy. 911 is a joke. You know what? Y'all gonna let me be the white Jesus in this bitch, because I don't believe in white Jesus. So I'm not blaspheming. So I'm gonna speak in parables. I'm gonna speak in subliminals. And I'm gonna call names, because if you don't like it, see me about that shit. Jamila, what's this shit about you and Curie? Because it's too late to call you. You know, you got a baby and everything. I don't want to upset your household. You know, like you say, you got to do a client. But then I look up later, you doing a motherfucking, I ain't, but you know, that little shit you see in LA about Donna and this and that. You could have said that shit to me. But let me tell you something. I owe nobody no motherfucking loyalty as far as what, I mean, I can be anywhere that I want to be. My husband don't tell me what the fuck to do. And I respect the hell out of him. And I don't give a fuck what an outsider say, what they see, because some of you bitches will never get married. Will never get married, never been married. And it's really fucked up when you got a lot of kids and nobody ever said, will you marry me? Because it's a bunch of motherfuckers out here that need a place to stay or need green cards. They will marry a bitch. So what's wrong with you motherfuckers? Motherfuckers claim they got businesses. Motherfuckers claim people blocking me. They around me for my motherfucking Curie. What the fuck is you talking about? Because I don't even know what the fuck is a Curie. Matter of fact, I'm going to look up what the fuck Curie mean. Because that little fucking screenshot. Look, I'm never mad at a motherfucker, and I don't hate him. But keep it fucking real. I'm too old to pussyfoot around the motherfucking bush. What the fuck is you really trying to say? Because what the fuck, Countess or whatever got going on with y'all ain't got shit to do with me. I was just shocked over there in L.A. room. I thought it was like, okay, this is a work, like they do in wrestling. Do they still call it that? Because I ain't never watched wrestling. But when I be sitting up with, you know, you sit up with your man or one of your three husbands and they all into Hulk Hogan or whatever, and you looking at the bullshit, and they say that's called a work. And I'm saying, well, y'all talk about women watching soap operas, but you motherfucker watch wrestling and know it's fake. Well, because, and then motherfuckers get involved and they have clubs. They every time this shit come out, they go buy tickets and they sell the fuck out. And I ain't hating on nobody's profession. But I want to know, what the fuck do Donna got to do with any of this bullshit? When I have kept it real with motherfuckers, I have apologized to Jamila twice. And she sat up there, but like somebody told me, they say she crazy as fuck. Don't trust her because she crazy. Okay, well, they say I'm crazy too. So why not better than to associate with her? But I never wanted her friendship. We were cordial. And I respected the fact that she accepted mine because I had spoke about her baby. But I never called him a motherfucker. I never called him slow. I never called him retarded. I said the reason why he wasn't talking like he should, I said, because you got all those demonic spirits over him. I don't know what the fuck I said. I got the video. I can pull that bitch out. I got receipts for everything that I've said. And those videos were taken down out of respect. But I got the receipts to show that I'm not lying. Now, what was said between us both on the phone together? You said the first time you said, I accept. Second time, and then later I see you was talking to me. Oh, yeah, you're going to pay. You ain't the only one with kids. And I'm a mother bear, too. I'm a mother lion, a lioness. I will go hard in the paint for mine, too. I feel you. We got that in common. But see, it seems like motherfuckers nowadays is trying to reinvent their motherfucking selves and trying to make motherfuckers forget what the fuck that motherfuckers is still saving in their collection. Kind of like when I sent out that motherfucking troll tape. And like I tell that showed me a lot of you hoes ain't getting no dick. Because if you was getting dick the fuck down, you would not be talking, bitch, until afterwards. The only talking I do during sex with my husband with his big ass penis is talking tongues. You hear me? And I ain't talking about the spiritual tongues. Oh, Shia. Oh, daddy. Oh, shit. Oh, go over there and check out Emoji Girl. What's up, Emoji? The songbird. I call her the songbird because I like her music. And I will support her. But what's up, Emoji? Like you say, us women need to stick together. And that's one thing in this world. And in social media, I'm going to keep on saying it. What's going on in the world is the pulse. Social media is really the pulse of what's really going on in the world to me. From my observations, from my studies of viewing things. This is not no roast video. It's not no, as y'all call it, because I'm too old. We used to call it capping in my day. Y'all call it roasting. I ain't roasting a motherfucker. It's just this. I say what I got to say because I don't want to disturb nobody this time of night. But guess what? The motherfuckers ain't sleep because it's going to be 15 views. As soon as I upload this, it's going to be 15 views before 15 minutes. So somebody up watching it. But I think Countess fucked herself up with people when she said that she had looked at a Donna marathon. She is not the only person that said that to me. Like I've said before, I know I talk a lot, long-winded. It can be content in what I'm saying or bullshit. And there is a method to my madness. I may go from subject to subject to see, are you still with me? Are you listening? Because you might be, I might be throwing out a little pearl of wisdom for you. But see, I have came to the conclusion that, especially for people that where I live, and they know who they are, they listen to me, where I live, I refuse to throw my pearl before swine anymore. That's in Proverbs. Look it up. And that means you don't throw your pearls before a swine is a hog. A hog will eat anything. They don't have sweat glands. That's why you develop high blood pressure. Or if you do have high blood pressure, you wonder why. But guess what? I got the motherfucking chitterlings, as it's spelled chitterlings. But, you know, black folks, we call it chitlins. You know what I'm saying? But chitterlings, the ones I buy the pre-clean. And I still go over them bitches 4 times. Sometimes 5. And they be pre-clean. Because you might find a piece of straw or a kernel of corn in that bitch. Throw some caps of bleach in that bitch. Like I was taught, when you boil that shit, you get you a little pot, one of your little raggedy ass pots, put some white vinegar in that bitch, boil it while you cook your chitlins. And when them bitches cook down, shit, especially when you get the red pill, that shit, your knuckles be froze up. But you know what? I was the weird kid that cleaned the chitlins. That was fun to me. Because they didn't have pre-clean when I was coming up. My mother get the red bucket. And that shit be frozen. And I had to take breaks, hands, your knuckles. But luckily, it's around holiday time. The heat on, your knuckles get crooked up like you got arthritis. Because it's frozen. But that was like the night before. She cooking all this shit. She done did her cakes and this and that. And everything put up. And some shit she do the night before. But you best to believe, I wasn't born on no trifling ass mother. She fed us. She didn't neglect us. And she had one man over us, my father. He never molested us. And he treated her like a fucking queen. And she stood up for herself. And you know what? He was a whore, too, that I found out. I wonder, do I got any siblings out there that I don't know about? Because I see a lot of motherfuckers that be favoring my. I'd be like, damn, she look like me. Or people say, you know, it's his coworker. My nephew got a person at his job. He said, you and his mom look just alike. And guess what? Doing little histories and talking to the lady when I ran into her. Guess what? She don't know who her daddy is. That's why people use, tell your kids, if your man step out on you or whatever, or if he, you know, tell your kids, like, you know, when I was with your daddy, he used to fuck around, or the chick name was this and that, you know, because, you know, you might fuck around and be fucking your brother and sister and marry him and wonder why the kids all fucked up and twisted up like ropes. No disrespect to nobody, kids got cerebral palsy or whatever. I'm just saying. You know, too much of the same thing ain't good, even in the animal kingdom. That's why these old crazy, stupid YouTube motherfuckers got them old retarded ass pit bulls in their house, because they backyard breeders, even in the animal kingdom. Even animals, if they may not have the same lineage and bloodline, but guess what? The motherfuckers be crazy up in the membrane. That's why they be
attacking their masters out of nowhere, or because somebody just walked across the floor, they attack mode for no reason. And you've been, they bit the hand that feed them. But that's what I'm getting to. Why motherfuckers want to bite the hand that feed them? And you ain't did shit for them financially because you don't feed them, you don't finance them, and don't fuck them. And please stop trying to act like me. Please, because people done sent me too many videos of a bitch. I'm just going to keep that one to myself. I asked my husband, I said, who does remind you of? He said, they look like you in the mirror. Wait, how you be acting? I said, thank you. I said, this bitch even used the same expressions I use. She wasn't doing that before. I done went through the whole videos. But all of a sudden, these motherfuckers trying to... And I ain't saying I'm nobody to cop y'all. You know? Shit. Copy off Cardi B or somebody. Beyonce and shit. But what you can't copy off, you may not have a scar on your tummy because maybe you can't have kids or you was pushing them out your raggedy ass pussy with no grippers left. But know this. My pussy tight than a motherfucker. My pussy tighter than Dick's Hat Man. And my husband go to work every day. I have to be there at 7. And he's going to continue to work. And I'm going to make sure he's comfortable every time he's at home. Tonight wasn't a sex night. My son told me to keep my granddaughter off this motherfucker. So you can hear her, but you already done seen her. And I bet you these old crazy motherfuckers and sit down and copy their fucking picture. And I kept her picture for a while. Some motherfuckers said they wanted to eat my little granddaughter's vagina. And I couldn't even get mad, like I told L.A. I said, these bitches said, some motherfuckers said, it could have been a bitch, though. Old child molesting ass bitch. Even though I've been accused of being a child molester, like people trying to use reverse psychology on me. Well, it was Jamela. I'm just going to keep it real. She said that me, Tina, and Mike were had a child sex trafficking ring. I got that video, too. I apologize for saying what I said about the baby. And really, when I think about it, I really didn't go as far as other people did, calling him all kind of names. And, you know, and he's a beautiful little boy. Not because he's biracial. He's just a beautiful child. And he's not being starved. He's getting fed. He's growing like, if you look at him and pick, he's growing like a weed. He's getting so tall. He's going to be very tall. Because I didn't know Jamila was as short as she is. But her son is very, he's going to be a tall young man. Tall, handsome young man. But really though, people, y'all need to really do keep your name. Keep people's kids out your motherfucking mouth, for real. And that was something that, knowing that I'm really a child advocate and being in the line of work I used to be in, whether you believe me or not, if I never was in that line of work, the thing is, people have gotten so far with shit, they talk about people's kids. And these motherfuckers is, you know, and people clinging up on the motherfuckers that never even apologize to you. Fuck what kind of relationship you had. Y'all in the same state, why you ain't never fucking met? The nigga ain't gonna meet you because he's scared. Nigga talk so much shit, he don't know if he getting set up. You'll see me and L.A. meet up before you see Mike Mills and Jamila meet up, okay? Now, Jamila might be down for meeting up with him. Jamila, ain't nobody roasting you before you get your panties in a bunch. Call me, boo. You got the burner number. Call me. Me and Jamila done talked many a day off of this shit. We're not friends. We're cordial. We made peace. But just to keep it real, L.A. did sick her on me. She never did apologize to me, but it's all good. I extended the olive branch to her and said, forgive me. The first time, and then later on, oh yeah, Donna, you're going to get what you got coming. I ain't scared of no motherfucking body. I'm just that fucking cocky. I don't give a fuck what a motherfucker practice or into. You cannot do me. You cannot do me, my children, my son, or my husband. You can't do me. Especially the way I pray. You can't do me. You can sit up there and send it out. But every word, thought, or deed that's negative sent toward me, I continuously hurl it back at the sender. I continuously hurl it back at the motherfucking sender. And that's what you people need to start doing. Hurl it back at the sender. And cover yourselves with Yahshua's blood from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. But don't believe in no white, blue-eyed Jesus. I ain't racist, but he did not exist. But I'm going to be the blue-eyed white. And I ain't trying to copy off for Black Rampage, aka Chris. What's up to you, boo? But a lot of motherfuckers is upset about me being up in L.A.'s room. I'm trying to figure this shit out. I think in a minute, somebody going to come forth and tell me some shit. And and you know what? I'll say, okay, he said it. And what? We both done went back and forth. He still got videos up about me. I still got them about him. And The only time I took some videos down with Madam Black Ass, because she showed her motherfucking problem. She got with her dark ass melanin filled skin tone, which is nothing wrong with being a dark skinned woman. And I'm not the authority on it, because there's nothing wrong with having melanin. You're less likely to catch skin cancer than most people, you know. And melanin, it doesn't shock me with all these biracial unions, because you know what? It's something about, look up Queen Elizabeth when she had a man hung. Now, it may not have been for that exact thing, but he was like a black activist. Now, I don't know if he was from the UK, but I did see the video. It was real talk. He told her, if you take your bloodline and start mixing in, but which Queen Elizabeth has black blood in her family, but if you take it and mix it with a person of color, your family, your bloodline will sustain a lot longer. Well, I guess he didn't know what he knew, if he really was on it, because she does have black in her family. She does. And she knows it too. But Jamila, this is not a roast video, but if you want to take it there, in my spare time, we'll do this. Let's do it. But it's stupid. But what I don't understand, everybody got their opinions like assholes. Kira, you don't know me. Keep my motherfucking name out your motherfucking mouth, because it ain't your motherfucking real name. Sir, please keep my motherfucking name out your motherfucking mouth while you don't bring your business to YouTube, okay? Because I'm not Jamila, okay? I'm not Jamila. This is because I'm not Jamila. Let's put it like that. I am not Jamila. I don't give a fuck what you think you know, what you think you saw. Hell yeah. I did it. And ain't no motherfucker gonna come behind me and outdo that shit. And you still can't see vagina, breasts, or whatever. It's just a lot of hateful ass bitches. You know what's funny about you, and this has nothing to do with Jamila's room. I'm talking about in other rooms. It's some jealous ass bitches. They can't get no dick in real life. And they get jealous of another internet woman's presence in a room because you happen to say what's up to a nigga. You bitches need to get over yourself and cam the fuck up and show your real face, bitch. Please. Would a real bitches like Eminem say, would a real Slim Shady please stand up? Would a real bitches with real faces, which they do. Bitch, let everybody see what you're working with. Don't be shaming yourself. Stop showing your hands or this and that. But you can put down another woman talking about she got long titties and this and that. Bitch, what kind of titties you got? What kind of ass you got? Do you got any spots on your ankles? Because you wear dollar store, beauty supply anklets, or real platinum ones of gold that your husband buy you for just because, or he may be in a doghouse and he's trying to get right with you and your ankles swell because you might be drinking shit. That's why I got a continuous prescription. The shit pile up, I give it away. Hydrochlorothiazide, water pills. Not the kind you can buy them in a drugstore, but if I've been drinking Nicki, I'm a lush. Well, let me be a lush, not around my granddaughter. If I'm a lush, but guess what? Your words can't tear me down. It can't bring me down. I'm like Christina Aguilera. I'm beautiful in every special way. Words can't bring me down. I'm beautiful, or you're beautiful. Don't let them bring you down. That goes for you too, man. They're going to talk about you. Just know this. When you're the subject of just know this. When your motherfucking name is called by a first name basis on some bullshit like this, and you're not getting paid for it, but you are kind of getting paid for it on a DL low key time,